Hello, I'm DJ Oliver and welcome to Detroit Performs. Today's show features designers of all sorts, and we're touring artist and designer Dominic Pangborn Studio, who on top of many other art forms, designs ties for high-end retail stores. Let's start out by getting more in depth with who Dominic is.
I'm influenced by all creativity of the past, you know, and probably the most important is Da Vinci, and not because of his painting, but his concept of being a Renaissance man, that he's done everything, and that's what I want. There is no one style, one technique, medium. I go entire spectrum, A to Z, from photographic realism to the non-representational abstract, you know, that could be simple as it's just one dot or splatter on it and say that's it. And the key there is just knowing when to stop. The creativity is really the essence of my art, and I think it all began with my childhood. I was born in Korea back in 1952, and I think that was very, very important to my life because 1952 was 1 year before the end of the Korean War. And so imagine at that point in time, Korea had nothing. My family had nothing. And so to me, it's a blessing as a creative person to be born at a place with nothing. Because I discovered later in life that when you don't have anything, that's the moment you have to think and you have to create, you have to invent, and you have to make things with what you got. For me, this is, I think, where I have the blessing. You know, I never run out of ideas. I have more ideas than I could ever produce in my life. And everything I see, everything I talk to someone, it generates an idea. And ideas just simply flow into me. And most of it through problems. When someone says, you can't do this, oh my God, I love it. I mean, my heart just goes to like, you want to bet? And I want to solve the problem. I'm fascinated with anything that's sort of the illusion, or the art of illusion. I came from Jackson, Michigan, and I used to see a lot of billboards out in the country roads. You know, every time we went for a drive, you saw billboards. And I got to a point that I hated them. But I wanted to have, when you drive by or walk by, it's gonna stop somebody. It wasn't until after school one day, I was walking home and walking down Michigan Avenue, and in front of John Hancock Building was this construction barricade. Instead of being a flat wall, they designed it as a accordion fold. And so as I walked up north direction, I got one set of message, and then when I turned around, they had another set of message on the other side. And that's when that three-dimensional concept came into play. So that was really the creation, the concept back in 71 that I got into this. And it wasn't until 1978 when I moved to Detroit, and one of the first projects I got working for a company here was, could you design a stage? So I went into my room, cut up some paper, and I created one of these 3D pieces. And then during that time, Daewoo Corporation out of Korea saw me one day and said, can you design some neckties? And I said, well, sure, I'd love to. So I designed some really, you know, colorful ties, and they got so excited, and they said, but these are too nice. And they said, it belongs to Saks Fifth Avenue. And so it became a big, huge hit. I think creative process basically evolves from the customers. As much as, you know, in the world of fine art, it's my self-expression, but at the same time, I'm doing it for a reason, and that reason to me is it's all about sharing. None of it is possible without the assistance of somebody, you know, whether it's the Pangborn family that was, you know, they had 11 children of their own, and yet they're willing to adopt another child. And so to me, the best thing in life, the most rewarding thing, is really giving back to the community. And I'm mentoring a young person just by coincidence that happens to be very similar in story. You know, she herself was adopted. every moment in my life, I call it happy accident, you know. About a year ago, a friend of mine from Dallas, he had emailed me and said, I have this patient, young girl that incredibly talented. So when I opened her file, one of her painting hit me right away, and it was like, wow. So I immediately took upon to like, okay, I'm gonna do something.
When I went to camp up here this summer, we finally got time to work with each other, and he showed me the splatter techniques and how to blend colors cool and how to just get big blobs of paint, just pour it on and just, you know, paint.
You can also take like a chisel and just create almost like the leaves. Just not too much, just so.
I think he just has a skill of talking to people and just, you know, persuading them, and he's really helped me like come out of my shell some, to be more comfortable talking and gaining more confidence through my artwork, and the show really helped me do that.
I think we inspire each other. You know, what I see, what she's doing, and sometimes I discover that when you're trying to teach somebody, you're actually learning more for yourself. And also she has a fresh eye, you know, that's different from mine. And so when she sends me a photograph, and I'm like, wow, I really, really love this. And it's, I don't know, triggers some brain cell that says, why don't you create this and that? And it's not that I'm taking her photograph, but that photograph is taking me into another level of doing something.
We were working on the painting with like the sky. That was my painting I did. And he was just like, we just need to add just a little bit of touches to it to make it really pop. He's like, try something else, you know? And so I kind of took a paint and splattered like he did, and it really turned out good. And I've become more into abstract artwork.
Good job.
Yeah.
To find out more about Dominic Pangborn and Shay White, head to DetroitPerforms.org.